Good evening and welcome to the Kennett Gymnasium for tonight's game between the Kennett Indians at their court warming and the Dexter Bearcats. I'm Terry McVeigh, and with me making his television debut is the longtime radio voice of the Kennett Indians, Darrell Wilcox.
Thank you, Terry. I'm glad to be here tonight. Thanks, Tyler, for asking me. I think it should be a good contest tonight. Both teams very similar records anyway, just a little flip-flop.
Yeah, Kennett's 10-11, Dexter's 11-10. They played each other in championship game of the Bloomfield Christmas Tournament. Kennett came up with the fourth quarter rally to pull that one out.
Patented defense that Kennett does.
Then that's what won. That's what won that game. Both teams play in the CMO conference. Each of them won one conference game. Kennett beat Notre Dame, and Dexter beat New Madrid. Dexter, since the Bloomfield tournament, Kennett's only won three games, and they're kind of on a skid. They've lost the last four in a row. Dexter, since Bloomfield, has won eight of their 10 games. And of course, they've played one tournament and made third place in that. So, Dexter's kind of on a better roll than Kennett right now, but they're 11-10. Kennett's 10-11. They were within 4 points of each other in Bloomfield, so I would expect we ought to have a good one.
And you would think after Kennett losing to their, quote, longtime rival Zenith Hornsville on Tuesday, that would give them even more incentive to come back for this ball game.
Yes, I would think so. That was a surprise, but when you got a guy like Kyle Moore who's dropping 49 on you, that's tough in a high school game when one guy
I'm telling you, you scored
49 points.
Good player. I believe they're going to have the national anthem performed by the a cappella group Voca Bella.
An excellent rendition.
Tell you what, those girls can really sing. Beretta Sexton has put together a fine group there.
Well, over the years, Beretta has done so much in music in Kennett, Southeast Missouri area. Okay, we're about ready for the opening lineups. Number 11 for Dexter is Jason Durrell, 5'11 junior. Number 21, Jacob Pettigo, a 5'10 senior. 24, Ethan Flowers, a 5'9 senior. 25, Tyler Heil, a 5'11 senior. And big man Gabe Jackson, 6'4 sophomore.
And for the Kennett Indians.
First, for the honorary team captain.
For Kennett, at their court warming game.
At guard. 6 foot senior, number two.
6 foot senior, number two, Grand Trail Carruthers.
At guard, 5'8 senior, number 22, Jahada.
Jahada Childress, 5'8 senior, number 22.
Number 12,
Patrick Maddox, 6 foot sophomore.
Forward, a 6'1 senior.
And 6 foot senior, Fred Gooden. And for rounding out, the 6'4 junior, Jad Kinney for Kennett. Kennett will be wearing white, trimmed in black. They'll be going right to left on your screen. Dexter's in black, trimmed in red. They'll be going left to right.
The contest before this one, the JV contest between both these teams, went into overtime and a big win for the Kennett Indians on that one by 1 point, 54-53. We hope that the varsity Indians can do equally as well for the home crowd, a court warming. But Dexter's a tough basketball team.
Well, Dexter's JV's only lost two or three games this year. That was a big win for the Kennett JV.
I understand that the go-to man for the Dexter Bearcats is number 35, Gabe Jackson.
He sure was in the Bloomfield tournament. Kennett for three quarters they had no answer to it, and they finally slowed him down in the fourth quarter, and Kennett won the game. But Dexter has some other
Dexter with the basketball.
Some other weapons, such as Ethan Flowers, who's a three-point master. And also Jason Terrell, the guy with the ball.
Speaking of Flowers, there's the first shot of the night, and he misses it, but ball comes down to Jackson. Up and in. First 2 points of the ball game belong to the Dexter Bearcats. Now in the front court, Kennett with it. There's a drive down low, dump it down to their big man, Jad Kinney.
Big game by Kinney would really bode well for Kennett. He's been playing much better of late.
Played really well against Sykeston. Now Dexter with it. Front court, way out front. Flowers. Now on the drive and a charge. Patrick Maddox picks up a lot of charges.
He does. He stands his ground well. He's a good defensive player.
First foul of the ball game. Now Kennett in the front court. Childress with it. Gets it back. Out front. Has it stolen. And shot up and good by Pettigo.
Pettigo's been adding some offense to Dexter lately. He scored 21 in a game earlier this week or late last week. So he's been adding a little more offense to give them some more options.
Now out front. Gooden with it on the right wing. Jump shot. In and out, back in. Ball game tied. Really two equally matched ball clubs.
Yeah, you look at the director, you look at where they've been, and they are very evenly matched.
Jason Gerald drives the lane, puts it up and in. They've got, both have the classic big man, and then the speedsters on the outside. Childress with a three, in and out, but picked up by Maddox. Now a miss on the third, on the trifecta. He goes out of bounds, goes back to Dexter. They'll try to add to that lead.
One thing Kennett really has to watch is shot selection. Sometimes they get way in too big a hurry and put up shots way too early in the running their offense.
They do that quite a bit. They have all this talent out there, but you don't have to be in a hurry. There's no shot clock. Dexter, good ball movement. Shot up, no good. Rebound, though, by Gooden of Kennett. Lead pass to Maddox. Maddox with a three. Going to be short. Comes down Dexter. Flowers with it out front. Pettigo, right side, Howe. Jason Gerald from the free throw line, no good.
Good block out by Kenny. Kept Jackson on his hip, got the rebound. Good pass, had him on his hip again.
The good pass down low to Carruthers.
That was good hustle, good court awareness by both Kenny and Carruthers.
Carruthers felt the presence of Jackson on his shot underneath, had to change it up, but still had the presence of mind to come after it. And with
good
the
hustle
held
by
ball.
Kennett. Nice hands by Childress, knock it free, and then good with the hustle to get the loose ball or get the jump ball.
Both teams.
Well, we call it a jump ball. We remember when we would have jumped
that. That's what
we
called it.
Alternate possession.
Now, Kennett with it in the front court. There's a
good defense
steal
by Pedigo. Nice hands.
Gerald drives. Kyle out front. Pedigo. Dexter content to just keep that ball out there and find something open. A cut probably down the lane.
Kennett's not giving him anything.
Kyle looking for Jackson.
Kennett's trying to double Jackson whenever they can.
Flowers, 3-point, good.
He's good at that.
Tell you what, Kennett doesn't need to allow him to shoot very many of those. And right back at him, down the other end, Jad Kinney.
Good drive by Carlos Turner, good driving dish. It's Kinney 4.
Edward Wilson in now, put speed against speed out there. Oh. Jackson just muscles in there and grabs that rebound, puts it back up and in.
He now has 4 in the game. Dexter leads by 3.
Jad Kinney has it knocked away by Gerald underneath.
Had a good mismatch there if he could have corralled that. He had Gerald guarding him underneath, he could have gone right over him.
Comes up with it after missing it. Now Wilson.
Ryan Mayo in the game.
There's
for Dexter.
Shot up, no good. Rebound though by Kinney. Stolen away.
Now Gerald got him when Kinney brought the ball down. He had the ball underneath, but he brought the ball down to his knees, and that makes
classic
Gerald just as big as he is.
A lot of the big men like to do. Flowers will drive down the lane. Nice little floater.
Now, good change of pace by Flowers on that dribble.
Kennett. Flowers says, I'll turn around and shoot it. Now, Gerald with a 3 from the right side. No good. Missed everything. Kennett comes down with it. Good in a transition. Dumps it out to Turner. Turner with a drive, can't get it to go. Jackson with the rebound.
Dexter up 13-8, less than a minute to go.
Biggest lead of the night for the Bearcats.
And again, Kennett's been a little quicker in their shots in their offense. Huh?
Yes.
Last couple of times down.
Whereas you see Dexter taking quite a bit of time looking for either the cut man that's going down the lane or an open man down low like Jackson. And the occasional 3-point bucket by Flowers.
Yeah.
Ball knocked out of bounds by Kennett. It will remain with the Bearcats.
And Carruthers and Maddox back in for Kennett. Kennett, as we've seen all year, Kennett substitutes a lot. And that's one thing that they do have over Dexter's, they have a deeper bench.
Got Carroll with a nice shot up over the top, hit and in. 7-point lead for Dexter with under 20 seconds to go in his first quarter. Down low. Can't come up with it. Dexter does. Pettigo off to Gerald. Down low to Jackson. A little turnaround. No good. And that's the end of the first quarter. Strong second half of the quarter for Dexter.
Yeah, and didn't seem that dominant until you look at the scoreboard. Okay, we'll be right back after this.
I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. I'm for working hard for what you get and then protecting what you've got. Your home, your vehicles, your life. I'm for making an honest living and taking pride in what you do. And for giving back to the community I call home. I'm for serving my clients with the respect and dignity you would expect from the farmers that started this company. And though I know you probably hope you never need me, I'm here for you when you do. I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent, and if you're a Missourian, I'm for you.
Darrell Wilcoxon here with Wilcoxon's Home Place Furniture and Appliance, 901 South Bypass, Kennett, Missouri. As a matter of fact, 901 South Bypass under construction, Kennett, Missouri. Yes, the path of progress is cutting right through our front yard. It's a bit of a pain to get here, but if you make the effort to get here, we'll make it worth your while on savings on furniture and appliances. That's Wilcoxon's Home Place Furniture and Appliance, 901 under construction, South Bypass, Kennett, Missouri. A family furniture tradition for over 65 years.
All right, we're back for the second quarter here in the Kennett Gymnasium. The game between Dexter and Kennett. Dexter's up 15-8 as we start second quarter. They have the ball. Joe Dexter has the ball.
Can't go with it out front. Guarded by Carruthers. Now gives it off to Gerald. Flowers dumps it to Jackson. Looked like he was going to take the three. Thought better of it.
He's looking for it.
I think when he walks across that mid-court line, he's looking. There's a nice drive by Heil. Couldn't get it in, but there's Jackson to put it right back up.
He's leading scorer in the game now with 6.
Kennett at the other end of the floor. Need to take their time and find some good open shots. There's Gooden with a 3. You don't see him shoot a lot of 3-pointers.
That's first 3 for Kennett in the game, and Gooden now has 5, and Kennett's 11. He just gets the foul.
Now both teams with 1 foul apiece.
That foul is on Carruthers, excuse me. Since Carruthers got his hair cut, he looks like Gooden. It keeps me confused. I'm glad they wear numbers.
Carruthers got a little bit of facial hair.
Yeah.
They both have that kind of cut, though, on their haircut.
Both have good lines.
There's Jackson again down low.
Kennett cannot let Jackson get the ball on the blocks. Once he gets there, he has good control, and he's going to score. He's so strong, he's going to go past anybody Kennett has.
He's going to control it underneath there if they'll just let him. And there's Gooden with another drive and another bucket. He's got 7.
Yeah, he's being the offense right now for Kennett.
That's typically the way it works for Kennett. They find the hot hand, and that person will take over and score for a while. Dexter on the other end will, though, always look, their number one offensive threat is going to be Jackson. Foul down underneath on Childress.
Yeah, Dexter's offense is going to, they're looking for Jackson on the post somewhere. Sometimes he'll get it out on the high post and he can feed underneath, but they're looking to run a post offense.
There's a nice steal by Turner. Gooden comes up with it and loses it. I would have thought he would have called timeout. And then Gerald picks it up and brings it back the other way.
Yeah, he either could have called timeout or just gone out of bounds with it. Would be better than throwing it back in right to
Absolutely.
A Dexter player.
I don't know that I want to just give him a freebie, but.
A foul's on Flowers, his first, his team second. Eddie Wilson back in for Kennett.
He takes the inbounds pass, gives it back now, gets it back out front. Turner with a three. First points of the night for Carlos.
Turner's somebody that Kennett can rely on if he gets high. He and Childress both can shoot threes.
Gerald, nice over the top over Kenny.
Is Gerald late? Good defense by Flowers. Good hands, knock it out of bounds, or almost a steal for a layup.
Pretty good defense on Turner to keep from letting Flowers get to it. Kennett brings it in. Edward Wilson with it out front over to Gooden. He'll try another three. This one's going to be short. Comes down, though, out long to Turner.
Hey, Dexter's playing a 2-3 zone. So far, Kennett's been content just to play it on the perimeter instead of trying to get something inside.
And a charge called on Edward Wilson. Might have forgot that he was playing basketball instead of football and lowered that shoulder a little bit.
He's better at avoiding people.
Tell you what, Jason Gerald is just about as quick as Edward Wilson is out on the basketball court. And next, there's a steal by Kenny. And a slam.
That'll get the crowd up. Like nothing Dell.
There's a kind rim to Gabe Jackson right there.
Well, he's got a good touch. He's getting the ball underneath. He's going to score. But the foul's going to be on.
Looks like it's going to be on Dexter.
It's going to be on Dexter.
I thought the way Maddox was reacting,
I thought it was on Kennett too. But it's going to be on Jackson.
Wow.
That's his first.
That's on Jackson?
Yeah. His first, team third.
I did not see that.
All right, we'll be right back with this timeout.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you.
We're never having kids.
I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, talk to State Farm agent Chris Brannan in Dexter. State Farm is there.
All right, we're back at the Kennett Gymnasium. 3:29 left in the second quarter. Dexter's ahead of Kennett, 25-18. Darrell, seems like every time Kennett makes a run or does something to get the crowd going, then Dexter scores about four really quiet points and extends their lead.
Tell you, there's a classic Kennett not looking for a pass, assuming that the guy with the ball is going to take the shot. That happens a lot to the Indians.
Yeah, and Kenny didn't have a shot. He was way underneath the basket. He didn't have a good shot to the basket.
Oh. Kyle got a little high dribble on there, but they get it back.
I'm impressed with Dexter's patience on offense because Kenneth tries to speed the team up.
And that ball, one official says one way, the other says, I believe it's actually Dexter's ball.
It is Dexter's ball. It was off of Carruthers.
Miscommunication between the two Kennett Indians.
That's two times in a row. Two turnovers in a row.
Flowers, oh my goodness. Had Thomas been turned around, that would have been an easy pickoff. Now the Bearcats throw it away.
Yeah, they speed it up a little bit on that possession.
Just a indication that you speed it up in high school basketball, you usually get a turnover instead of a good solid shot. Not to say there aren't some teams that play well that way. I'm not so sure he actually had a hold of that ball.
I don't think he did it. Well, where that ball ended up, I hope he didn't have a good hold on it. We'll say he didn't because
we're going to say he didn't.
He's a better shooter than that.
Well, Dexter's going to have it. They have a 7-point lead. And Flowers will bring it up. It was 7 at the end of one, and it's back to 7 again. The Indians have gotten it below that several times, but Dexter keeps bringing it back up. Now they're back to taking their time on their offensive. Gerald and Flowers content to play with it out front until they get a good open, either look to Jackson or a drive down the lane. There's Pettigo with a three, gonna be off the mark, but there's Jackson. But Kenny, good defense.
Good movement by Kennett.
That was
Carruthers,
really
good. And that's Carruthers' game where he's best in it on offense, and he's slashing towards the bucket. That foul's on Heil. It's first. First free throws of the game.
And he hits the first one.
Then at 13 left in the second quarter, first free throws of the game for either team.
Second free throw, no good, but.
And Carruthers steals, draws a foul.
Gerald picks up his first foul tonight.
That was Gerald, I believe, got that one, but his first.
Now they're saying Jackson.
They gave it to Jackson.
Wow.
That's his second. I would think he'd come to the bench. I sure don't want him to get his third.
Thomas with a drive.
I guess he's going
third.
To.
Wow.
Good move by Kenneth's part to go right at Jackson.
Absolutely. It would bode well for Kennett to get him out of the ball game.
Oh, good Lord, yes. That's his third. He's still on the court.
Coach's nightmare for your big man to get a third foul before the end of the first half. Thomas missed
Still question whether that second flower that they gave Jackson, whether that was on him.
Well, I didn't think it was.
It was on, I thought it was on Gerald.
Now there's a foul on Kennett.
It's going to be on Wilson, I believe.
Webb came up with a rebound. And Wilson picks up the foul, hits his second.
Team fourth. Now Wilson comes to the bench. They don't want him getting his third. Childress in for him.
Gerald hands it off to Flowers. He'll bring it up the floor. Under a minute to go in this first half. Dexter looking to get it down low. Gerald with it, now to Pettigo. Back to Gerald. Pettigo with a three. It's all. Kennett comes over the rebound. Lead pass to Jad Kinney. Oh, and he just threw it away.
He was trying to get it to Thomas, and Thomas wasn't looking for it.
Just another case where
three times this quarter.
Not looking for a pass. Assumptions can kill you. Gerald with a nice shot off the window.
He has 10 in the game now.
Childress with a long bomb. And the Indians go down to the Bearcats at half by 8.
All right, halftime, 27-19. Draver Dexter will be back after a word.
For more than 75 years, the law firm of Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, has served the legal needs of Southeast Missouri. Located at 308 First Street in Kennett, Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, is a full-service law firm providing representation in a wide range of areas, such as personal injury, workers' compensation, family law, criminal law, probate, business, and estate planning. For all your legal needs, call Crow, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, at 573-888-4664.
You just can't do it anymore, but you want to stay in your own home. Bales is the place to call. Bales is committed to helping people like you to maintain your independence and live your life on your terms with dignity. Bales can help with your family getting paid for taking care of you. There is no need to live anywhere but our own home with Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services there to help. Just call 888-449-0949 or stop by 719 Tico Road in Kennett to find out more. Bales, Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services, serving Dunklin, New Madrid, Pemiscot, and Stoddard counties.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
Edward Jones, this is Shirley speaking. How may I help you? Oh, hey, Neil. How are you? How was the trip?
With nearly 7 million investors.
It's right here. Hold on one sec.
You'd expect us to have a highly skilled call center.
Kevin, Neil Hawley's on line one.
Okay, great.
And we do. It's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing.
My name is Dustin Mayer. I operate Mayer Law Office, which is a full-service law firm located in Dexter, Missouri. I practice personal injury, criminal defense, workers' compensation, family, and other areas of law. As an assistant Missouri Attorney General and assistant prosecuting attorney, I've had the opportunity to try multiple cases in front of juries, and I'm willing to put that experience to work on your behalf. I'm a Southeast Missouri native, and if you hire me, you'll get the big firm experience with a small town touch. Call today for your free consultation.
Introducing Pizza Hut's first $5 flavor menu. Your Pizza Hut favorites, just $5 each when you order two or more.
So, two medium pizzas, just $5 each?
Yes.
Well, all right.
Can we get Wing Street Wings for $5 each?
Yes. Can we get pasta? And how about a Hershey's cookie? Yes and yes.
Can I get pizza for the whole team?
You got it, Mr. Cuban. Just $5 each.
Yes!
It's easy to say yes to our first ever $5 flavor menu, only at Pizza Hut.
I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. I'm for working hard for what you get and then protecting what you've got. Your home, your vehicles, your life. I'm for making an honest living and taking pride in what you do. And for giving back to the community I call home. I'm for serving my clients with the respect and dignity you would expect from the farmers that started this company. And though I know you probably hope you never need me, I'm here for you when you do. I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent, and if you're a Missourian, I'm for you.
Tonight's game brought to you in part by Bank of Advance. Bank of Advance has four locations to serve you in Dexter, Bell City, Advance, and Chaffee. The Bank of Advance wishes luck to all teams and understands the preparation, practice upon practice, for each game of the long season. Bank of Advance, where a handshake still matters. Member FDIC.
Save time this holiday season and shop the Ford Friends and Neighbors event at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
You've always had an inside deal with us.
We have got lower prices on our website, like this F-350, now only $52,346. This F-150, now only $31,534. This 2015 Taurus, now only $26,388.
Whether you come take a test drive or visit us on the web, you get the real inside deal here at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
And folks, if you've not been to the Winchester Place, come in and take a look at this facility. You don't know what you have missed.
We are very proud of this facility. A lot of people do not realize we're here, what we can offer to them, and what a facility we have. And we would like to have people come by anytime and tour us. You won't find a better place to live or better staff to take care of you anywhere Southeast Missouri. I'll guarantee it.
We are located at 400 Winchester Drive. Come down Bowman, and we sit on the corner of Bowman and Winchester.
Need a bigger house or looking to buy your first? Go with a lender you can trust, Montgomery Bank. Our mortgage professionals are ready to help you with low rates and great service.
Hi, I'm Tyler Hubrecht, your state representative. I'm working hard in Jefferson City, fighting to support access to health care for senior citizens, fighting to remove government from our schools and allowing our teachers to teach our children without their interference. I'm working hard to support job growth in our economy, and I appreciate very much your support. If you have any questions or comments, please email me at tylerhubrecht@house.mo.gov.
Forwards and backwards. Can you flip it over?
Whoa. While I may not be able to do your job, I'm here to help with all of your commercial or home lending. Our loans are simple and inexpensive. I'll get the job done with personal financial assistance at First National Bank, believing in community and preparing for the future.
It's nice, but you know what? I think I'm going to stick to the banking job.
When there's no light at the end of the tunnel, no hope, I just lose the will to move ahead.
God will supply you with the strength to do all that needs to be done on that day. So let go and trust in Him.
I'm so glad I don't have to go it alone anymore.
Let the Lord Jesus be your strength right now. A message from the First Baptist Church of Dexter, Missouri.
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
Okay, we're back for the second half of the action here in Kennett between the Dexter Bearcats and the Kennett Indians. Dexter's leading 27-19. I'm Terry McVay. With me, Darryl Wilcoxon. Darryl, your thoughts about the first half?
Well, the first half evenly matched through the first half of the first quarter, and then all of a sudden Dexter decided they were going to take their time looking for nice, easy buckets, and Kennett saw that as a chance for them to have to hurry up and throw the ball away, and then that's how they built that lead.
Yeah, you look at the game, you look at some of the plays that were made. Kennett made some really spectacular plays, including the dunk by Jad Kinney off of a steal. They made several steals. They did lots of things well, especially on defense. But then every time Kennett would score on some spectacular play, Dexter would come back and score 4 points and extend their lead. Every time Kennett would get it back to within four or five, that you look up and it's back to eight. So Dexter's been, I think, has been very efficient this game. They've played very well within their offense. And as you said, Kennett hurries theirs up a little bit too much and has committed lots of turnovers that were basically because of going too fast.
Yeah,
they were hurry-up turnovers.
The key for Kennett in the second half would be to, number one, send it into Kenny and try to pick up more fouls on Gabe Jackson. They had him with three. I don't know if that was accurate or not. I'm going to say it is because they're not even going to start him here in the second half. But you get him down low, and if Jackson comes back in, give it to Kenny, and you try to foul out their big guy who has 10 points in the first half.
Yeah, he has 10. Jason Gerald has 10, 5 for Flowers, 2 for Pettigo. Kenneth, Carlos Turner, 3. Fred Gooden leads with 7. Jad Kenny with 6. And 3 for Rantrell Crothers.
Well, I said they weren't going to start him in the second half.
He wasn't on the scoreboard, but he is starting. Kenneth's in white, trimmed in black, going left to right. Dexter's in the black, trimmed in red, going right
to
left. Kenneth with the ball.
Get it down, try to get him to pick up some more fouls. Looks like Kenneth got the message about taking their time. Kenny takes it up. No good. Rebound came down to Maddox, but he couldn't corral it.
But that was a good possession. They ended up with a good shot. They got the ball to Kenny on the blocks.
And they
got a good
time.
Shot. They didn't make it, but that was a good possession for Kenny.
Now Dexter in their front court. Had to go. They'll take their time. Now Gerald
Kennett's always pressing on defense.
And Gerald took it to the big man. Carruthers with a drive. And it looks like, was that foul on Heil?
Yes. His second. Kennett was just 1 for 4 from the free throw line in the first half. Dexter has yet to shoot a free throw. Kennett's now 1 for 5.
Carruthers missed that free throw there, but almost came out and got the rebound. Heil with a nice put up, but couldn't make the shot. And a held ball situation, it'll go to Dexter.
Good hustle with Maddox. Both Maddox and Gerald on that underneath ended up with the tie-up.
Dexter looking to get it in, get it to Gerald. Now out front to Heil. Heil not very much of a threat to shoot the basketball unless, like earlier, he was down low.
That's why Kenny can, if Heil is anywhere close to the basket, they can slough off. They can and maybe give some help to Jackson.
Pettigo with the shot, but Howell with the rebound. Flowers tries to get it to Howell.
That's all on the floor. On the floor.
That's on 11.
Shot went in, but he
didn't count all
the foul on the floor.
Kennett with it.
Again, Kennett's done a lot of good things the first 2 minutes this half. They haven't cut the lead at all.
Kenny just can't hang on to the basketball. Well, it doesn't help, I think, that they throw it down at his feet. There's a long three-pointer by Flowers. I said earlier, you just can't let him get that open shot.
That's his second three of the game. Extends the lead to 11. We'll be back right after this timeout.
I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent.
I'm for working hard for what you get and then protecting what you've got. Your home, your vehicles, your life. I'm for making an honest living and taking pride in what you do, and for giving back to the community I call home. I'm for serving my clients with the respect and dignity you would expect from the farmers that started this company. And though I know you probably hope you never need me, I'm here for you when you do. I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent, and if you're a Missourian, I'm for you.
All right, we're back here for 5 minutes, 51 seconds left in the third quarter. Dexter up by 11, 32-21.
Yeah, like we said, Kennett needed to try to slow it down, run a good offense, find the good shot. Well, they've done that a couple of times down the floor. One time had a decent shot. Next time, couldn't hang on to the basketball.
Yep.
Ended up resulting in a fairly quick break down the floor for Dexter and a three-pointer.
Yeah, so, you know, Kennett's done some good things in this quarter, but Dexter has extended the lead. Dexter's been much more efficient. Now Dexter's going to come out and do a little pressure. 1-2-2.
Tyreek going to take it right to the hole.
I think that kind of pressure feeds, kind of plays into Kennett's hands.
I believe you're right. That opens up lanes that they don't have. Call a jump, what?
Jump ball.
That'll be Kennett possession, correct?
It is.
Well, a charging foul. Ryan Mayo stood his ground.
The third foul on Wilson. Wilson's usually really good about getting to the baseline. Don't know how far under the basket high was on that.
Dexter in the front court. Dump it down to Jackson. Out of Mayo, blocked from behind. Turner with a three.
Closest Kennett's been in a while. They're down six.
I think
official timeout. Got some. Oh, we got some blood.
We got some blood on a player.
He'll have to come to the bench.
The 11-point lead down to six. Gerald with a shot up, and now I'm a firm believer. If you're going to foul a player on a shot such as that, you might as well
don't
put
let
a good
him make
body
the shot.
On. Don't let him get that shot off.
Fouls on Gooden, his first. Team second.
Now, I don't believe they've ever put the points up on the board that now they have.
Well, they have put all
the
of
the basket with the free throw was good as well.
Yeah, 35, scores 35-26, 4:34 left in the third quarter. Dexter leads.
Carruthers going to drive. Should have put the shot up instead of nice drive by Pettigo.
I think that's going to be on Mayo.
That'd be his first, I believe.
It is. He was out of control and came in for the rebound.
Kenny reminds me of one of that old country song. They take two steps forward and then three steps back. So it's just
Kind of like the old story, it was so slick outside it, I couldn't get here because I took one step forward, two steps back. So they said, how'd you get here? So I turned around.
They dumped it down low to Kenny, but Gerald was there to knock it out of bounds. And so Kenny will remain with the basketball. And Childress. He'll take a three. Good. That's his first points of the night.
It is. That's it. It gets Kennett back to six.
Flowers need to get on him. There's a cross-court pass. Pettigo with a three-pointer. No good. Rebound by Turner. Turner will take a three.
He's feeling it. Turner is feeling it. That's his third three of the game.
Now down to 3 points. There's a missed shot by Mayo. Rebound comes down to Kennett.
Oh, nice play by Gerald.
Very fine play by Gerald.
He's going to turn it into a three-pointer. Boy, a good play by Gerald. That ball, everybody else giving up the ball to go out of bounds.
I think they all thought
he
it was going
it,
out.
He saves it, turns it into a three-pointer. Or a chance at it.
That foul on Turner, that's his first. And Pettigo makes the free throw as well. That 3-point lead now back to six. Nice move by Gooden to take it down, a little jump stop. Flowers with it. Pettigo shot up and in. Coach Vaughn, I believe, wants a timeout.
I believe so. We'll be back right after this.
Darrell Wilcoxon here with Wilcoxon's Home Place Furniture and Appliance, 901 South Bypass, Kennett, Missouri. As a matter of fact, 901 South Bypass under construction, Kennett, Missouri. Yes, the path of progress is cutting right through our front yard. It's a bit of a pain to get here, but if you make the effort to get here, we'll make it worth your while on savings on furniture and appliances. That's Wilcoxon's Home Place Furniture and Appliance, 901 under construction, South Bypass, Kennett, Missouri. A family furniture tradition for over 65 years.
All right, we're back.
All right, here we're back. 2:27 left in the third quarter here at Kennett. Dexter leads Kennett 40-34. And like the whole game, every time Kennett takes a good big step forward, they slide two back because here comes Dexter just playing very, very methodically and very economically.
It's the way that you
and with good plays like that one Gerald just made on defense.
Well, that was an excellent play by Gerald. Childress down low to Kenny, back to Childress.
Kenny's trying to get the ball underneath, take advantage of Jackson being on the bench.
Cross court pass, three-pointer off the mark, rebound by Maddox, and a foul on Heil.
That's going to be Heil's third. Good rebound by Maddox.
That'll send Maddox to the line to shoot two.
Kennett's only 1-for-5 from the free throw line.
Little Maddox line first, drive, but it goes in.
Maddox first points of the game. Now Dexter gets Jackson back in. They were able to play a good part of that third quarter without Jackson in the game.
I'm thinking if it were me, which of course is not, I think I'd have just left him out for the final 2 minutes of his third quarter and have him for crunch time. But down to a 4-point lead, 40-36. Good defense by Kenny.
Kenny was fronting Jackson. It's a good thing he has long arms and a good jumper, because if he doesn't deflect that ball, Jackson's got a layup because he was getting no help at all.
Dexter will inbound under their own goal. They get it in the corner. Flowers with a three, in and out. Rebound by Carruthers. They'll call that every time.
With two guys,
even if they don't move, it doesn't matter. If two players on the same team, that's.
Yeah, that call is going to be made.
I think the Kennett fans were looking for a little whistle on the drive, but.
That'd have been a tough whistle because Brothers was. He was creating all the contact.
There's a good steal by Kenny. Now Carruthers, and a foul from behind on Pedigo.
He hits second. Want to send Carruthers to the line for two, where he is 1-for-3 so far.
He makes this be down to two, and it hasn't been a two-point lead since the first quarter. And he does.
Then it's pressuring all over the court.
Flowers, Childress trying to guard him. Now down to Pedigo on the block. Swings it around, gives it to Gerald. A blocking foul on Gooden.
Call that on the floor. No shooting. No shots to take. That's his second foul on Gooden. Team foul 4 for Kennett in this half.
Gerald gets it in to Pedigo. The clock still hasn't started. Now it has. Jackson with it. Shot up. No good. Rebound by Kenny. Lead pass right in the hands of Flowers. Gerald didn't want to take that three. There was about a 3 seconds that didn't go off that clock.
Again, a great defensive play by Kennett, and they turned the ball over.
Dexter probably looking to take the last shot. Flowers with it out on the wing.
I think it's going to be Gerald taking it.
And we've got a foul on Kennett. I believe it's going to be on Kenny.
I believe so.
Nope, they say Gooden.
That'll be his third. Team foul 5, 4.7 seconds left in the quarter. Gooden takes the bench, don't want to get his fourth.
Nearly a steal by Carruthers. Shot up by Pedigo, no good. Rebound by Jackson, no good. End of the third quarter, 40-38, Dexter.
We'll be right back for the fourth quarter.
I am never getting married.
Never.
Guaranteed.
You picked a beautiful ring.
Thank you.
We're never having kids.
Mm-mm. I love it here.
We are never moving to the suburbs.
We are never getting one of those. We're never having another kid.
I'm pregnant.
I'm never letting go.
For all the nevers in life, talk to State Farm agent Chris Brannan in Dexter. State Farm is there.
For more than 75 years, the law firm of Crowe, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, has served the legal needs of Southeast Missouri. Located at 308 First Street in Kennett, Crowe, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, is a full-service law firm providing representation in a wide range of areas, such as personal injury, workers' compensation, family law, criminal law, probate, business, and estate planning. For all your legal needs, call Crowe, Reynolds, Shetley, McVeigh, and Shear, LLP, at 573-888-4664.
All right, we're back, Terry.
Okay, Darryl, hope you got your seatbelt on because I think you should strap in for a good fourth quarter. Dexter came out, or Kenneth came back, cut the Dexter lead from 9-2. It's a 40-38 game. Dexter starts with the ball in the fourth quarter.
But not before Dexter had actually built that lead up to 11. But they came out. Kennett played that second half of the third quarter really well. Flowers with a drive. Jackson with it. Gives it off Flowers. You can't leave him alone. And there it is, a three-pointer.
That's his third of the game.
Lead built back up to 5. Carlos Turner looking to get it down low. Turner will shoot a 3. It's off the mark. Kenny gets the rebound, though. Now Turner down the lane. Shot up. No foul on the big man. Wow.
Be off of Dexter. Ball to Kennett.
Big love there. Surprising. Kennett actually taking their time. Kenny with the bat. Oh, should have just took the shot. Tried to pass it off.
It's hard to make those close quarter passes underneath like that. Another turnover for Kennett.
Especially when you got 4 bunched in there together.
Well, he had Jackson guarding him. He goes over him, he either gets 2 points or he goes to the free throw line.
Could have been a good opportunity to put points on the board and get a foul on Jackson.
Okay, we just look up. Dexter's up by 7.
Patrick Maddox, oh, a little too strong. Foul on Maddox.
It's just his first. It's the 6th foul on Kennett, so Dexter's going to be in the bonus the rest of the way. Kennett substituting again, getting Eddie Wilson back in the game, along with Crothers and Thomas. Kennett's on pressure full court.
Kennett got it down to 2 to start this quarter, and then
Dexter with all their starters back in. Timeout, Dexter. We'll be right back with Dexter up 45-38.
You just can't do it anymore, but you want to stay in your own home. Bales is the place to call. Bales is committed to helping people like you to maintain your independence and live your life on your terms with dignity. Bales can help with your family getting paid for taking care of you. There is no need to live anywhere but our own home with Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services there to help. Just call 888-449-0949 or stop by 719 Tico Road in Kennett to find out more. Bales, Boot Hill Area Independent Living Services, serving Dunklin, New Madrid, Pemiscot, and Stoddard counties.
Don't keep going.
Okay, we're back. Score's 45-38. There's 6 minutes, 27 seconds left in this, Darrell. And Dexter has the ball. It's a big defensive stop for Kennett. You really don't want to get behind by 9 here in the fourth quarter. It's tough to keep coming back. Kennett's been doing it all night, but it's tough to do.
Kennett trying to do what they did at the Bloomfield Tournament, come back in that fourth quarter. Gerald with a nice drive, started with the left hand, put it up with the right. And there they are back.
Gerald's a pretty cool guy, a pretty cool customer out there. He just, Kennett overplays the ball lots of times. That's just their defense. And he took advantage of that and just took it down the lane for a layup and gets Dexter up by 9.
There's Childress with a 3, and it's in.
It's his second 3 of the game.
Kennett's hit about 5 three-pointers tonight. There's Gerald passes it off. Big man back out to Gerald. You won't see him take very many of those three-pointers.
But he will.
You'll see him do it and make it.
He's made 4 of them in this game. Back to 9.
If Kennett wants to win the ball game, they've got to keep Flowers from hitting the three. There's a good looking shot, just didn't go down.
Big stop again. I'd say it, Kennett can't get down by double figures.
No, if they get down double figures, it's pretty much over.
Because Dexter's not going to beat themselves.
And they're going to use lots of clock.
They're trying to shorten the game. They're going to stretch it out, use as much clock as they can. Kennett's going to try to make steals. They're going to take chances on defense. That's what they do. They do it all the time. Been doing it all game.
Gerald trying to elude his defender.
If they keep the ball in Gerald's hands.
There's a nice steal by Kennett.
Hey, Kennett doesn't have to be in a big hurry. They don't have to shoot threes. They got 4 minutes. There's plenty of time to score 11.
Thomas with a three, in and out. Big rebound by Kenny. Gets it up, puts it back in again.
That's Kenny's first point in the second half. This half. We'll be right back. It's 50-43. Ahead of Dexter's ahead.
Deposit your check here. Or here. Or even there. Deposit your check wherever you are with First Midwest Bank's new mobile deposit. Just tap, snap, deposit. It's that simple. New mobile deposit from First Midwest Bank, serving the communities we call home.
All right, we're back.
All right, we're back. 3 minutes, 48 seconds left in this, and I think it's going to get closer than this, Darrell. 7-point lead from Dexter. Kennett just scored. Dexter has the ball. Kennett's going to do a full court press. Man-to-man full court press where they take lots of chances and make lots of flashes at the ball. So let's strap it in for this last 3:48.
Let me tell you, that 3:48 is like a lifetime when you're out there on that court. Flowers, he'll dump it out.
Again, Dexter is going to be very efficient in trying to shorten the game, stretch out each possession. Oh,
nice look.
Was nice. Jackson got Kenny on his hip. There's nothing anybody can do to stop that.
Boy, probably not the best person to be taking that shot at that point.
Back to 9 points. There's his turnover.
Speaking of the big guys, that's Jackson's first points in the second half as well.
Again, Kennett.
I don't understand.
Kennett's not running the offense. They're just taking the first. They're taking the first available shot instead of the best available shot. Timeout, Dexter. But we'll be right back. It's a 9-point lead. 2:47 left.
Edward Jones, this is Shirley speaking. How may I help you? Oh, hey, Neil. How are you? How was the trip?
With nearly 7 million investors.
He's right here. Hold on one sec.
You'd expect us to have a highly skilled call center.
Kevin, Neil Hawley's on line one.
Okay, great.
And we do. It's how Edward Jones makes sense of investing.
My name is Dustin Mayer. I operate Mayer Law Office, which is a full-service law firm located in Dexter, Missouri. I practice personal injury, criminal defense, workers' compensation, family, and other areas of law. As an assistant Missouri Attorney General and assistant prosecuting attorney, I've had the opportunity to try multiple cases in front of juries, and I'm willing to put that experience to work on your behalf. I'm a Southeast Missouri native, and if you hire me, you'll get the big firm experience with the small town touch. Call today for your free consultation.
Okay, Darrell, we're back for the last 2:47 of this game. Dexter's up by 9. They have the ball. Kennett's pressuring.
Well, 9 seems like a lot of points, and 2:30-something seems like a short time, but it's opposite on both of those. It could easily be making up with a few steals by Kennett and some good, decent shots. But Dexter They have other plans. They're trying to hold that ball. Use up the clock. They've got it. The floor general has it, the Jason Gerald there.
Yeah, and they're not going to do anything except shoot layups from now on. They won't take another shot besides the layup.
Gerald going the free throw line. He'll have a one-on-one opportunity. That foul is on Turner.
Darrell's 2 for 2 from the line. Dexter's only shot 3 free throws. They've made them all.
Gerald's their leading scorer on the night. He misses that one. Kennett comes up with it. Now in the front court, and the lead man did not know the ball was coming. Shot up. No good. Rebound. Fought for. Goes off of Dexter and it goes to Kennett. 10-point lead. Reminds me of a song here. It's a ORB classic, too much, too little, too late, maybe, for the Kennett Indians.
Okay, it looks like Cape has beaten Sykeston tonight, 73-63.
Wow.
I never would have seen that coming. I mean, Kennett had Cape beat last week and fell apart for the fourth quarter. I didn't think anybody from Southeast Missouri was going to beat Sykeston.
Did maybe some of them not attend the game? 73-63,
10-point win for Cape over Sykeston.
Sykeston,
number one
court.
Ranked team in Class 4.
And they're a good basketball team. And shot up a little floater. And it goes down for Turner.
Kennett's got a foul.
There's
or
a
steal.
Childress will shoot a three. It's going to be off and it's going to be short, but it's going to be picked up by Kennett.
114.
Now Gooden will take a three. And it's in.
Gets it back to 5. Timeout. We'll be back. 110 left. It's a 5-point game. Strap it in, Daryl.
Introducing Pizza Hut's first $5 flavor menu. Your Pizza Hut favorites, just $5 each when you order 2 or more.
So, 2 medium pizzas, just $5 each?
Yes.
Well, all right.
Can we get Wing Street Wings for $5 each?
Yes. Can we get pasta? And how about a Hershey's cookie? Yes and yes.
Can I get pizza for the whole team?
You got it, Mr. Cuban. Just $5 each.
Yes!
It's easy to say yes to our first ever $5 flavor menu, only at Pizza Hut.
I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent. I'm for working hard for what you get and then protecting what you've got. Your home, your vehicles, your life. I'm for making an honest living and taking pride in what you do. And for giving back to the community I call home. I'm for serving my clients with the respect and dignity you would expect from the farmers that started this company. And though I know you probably hope you never need me, I'm here for you when you do. I'm a Missouri Farm Bureau insurance agent, and if you're a Missourian, I'm for you.
All right, we're back. There's 1:10 left in this game. Dexter's up 53-48. They have the ball. Take it over, Daryl.
Well, I tell you what, Dexter will bring it in, and Kennett will only have one choice. To try to steal quick, and if they can't steal quick, then they're going to have to foul.
You don't want to foul that guy.
But that's not the guy you want to foul. And you really don't want to foul Gerald either.
But they want to keep the ball in Gerald and Flowers' hands.
Going to have to foul
have
now.
To do something.
Got to do something.
45 seconds left.
You can't just.
They finally foul Flowers. You don't want to foul their best shooter, but he's the guy with the ball.
I believe I would have fouled about 20 seconds ago myself.
Well, when Jackson had the ball. Or
yes.
Flowers would shoot 1-1.
And he misses.
Kennett with the rebound.
Got the hurry. Shot up by Turner, no good. Rebound, only people there is Dexter. Gooden picks up the foul. That's his fourth.
It is, but that's a foul he had to give.
What's it? Shame that shot couldn't gone down and make the suspense even more here at the final seconds.
This is the last one on one. After this, it's double bonus. He missed. Kennett needs to get down in a hurry.
And missed the drive. And a foul on Childress. That's going to put Flowers back to the free throw line.
This time it's two. He'll shoot two.
Looks like Dexter's going to avenge that loss at the Bloomfield Christmas Tournament. Second free throw is good as well. That builds it back up to that 7-point lead.
Yeah, it's three. It's three possession now, less than 20 seconds.
Gooden with a three off the mark. Kenny jumps it back out. Turner with a three off the mark. Hits the top of the backboard. Now to give it to Dexter.
9.3. Looks like Dexter Bearcats are going to win their second SEMO Conference game of the year. But
Pedigo will inbound it for the Bearcats. Get it into Flowers. Flowers has it knocked away, brings it back up, gives it off to Pedigo. Under 5 seconds.
Dribble it out.
And that's the end of the ball game. The Bearcats win this one by 7, 55-48. We'll be right back.
Tonight's game brought to you in part by Bank of Advance. Bank of Advance has four locations to serve you in Dexter, Bell City, Advance, and Chaffee. The Bank of Advance wishes luck to all teams and understands the preparation, practice upon practice, for each game of the long season. Bank of Advance, where a handshake still matters. Member FDIC.
Save time this holiday season and shop the Ford Friends and Neighbors event at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
You've always had an inside deal with us.
We have got lower prices on our website, like this F-350, now only $52,346. This F-150, now only $31,534. This 2015 Taurus, now only $26,388.
Whether you come take a test drive or visit us on the web, you get the real inside deal here at Harry Blackwell Ford in Malden.
And folks, if you've not been to the Winchester Place, come in and take a look at this facility. You don't know what you have missed.
We are very proud of this facility. A lot of people do not realize we're here, what we can offer to them, and what a facility we have. And we would like to have people come by anytime and tour us. You won't find a better place to live or better staff to take care of you anywhere Southeast Missouri. I'll guarantee it.
We are located at 400 Winchester Drive. Come down Bowman, and we sit on the corner of Bowman and Winchester.
Need a bigger house or looking to buy your first? Go with a lender you can trust. Montgomery Bank. Our mortgage professionals are ready to help you with low rates and great service.
Hi, I'm Tyler Hubrecht, your state representative. I'm working hard in Jefferson City, fighting to support access to health care for senior citizens, fighting to remove government from our schools and allowing our teachers to teach our children without their interference. I'm working hard to support job growth in our economy, and I appreciate very much your support. If you have any questions or comments, please email me at tylerhubrecht@house.mo.gov.
While I may not be able to do your job, I'm here to help you with your commercial and all of your lending needs. Our loans are simple and inexpensive. I'll get the job done with personal financial assistance. First National Bank, believing in community, preparing for the future.
What is your emergency?
Need assistance at County Road 61 and Highway 9.
Help is on its way.
Clear!
There's a better way to jumpstart your soil back to health. Apply Enzone to protect and increase nitrogen efficiency without killing bacteria. Apply Prevent to increase phosphorus availability and reduce fixation. Better yet, use them both to get more from your fertilizer investment and see higher potential yields. Ag Explorer, your prescription for healthy soil.
Okay, we're back to wrap this up. Durwood Dexter Bearcats have defeated the Kennett Indians in SEMO Conference action, 55-48. Your thoughts about the game, Darrell?
Well, Kennett looked like they were poised for a comeback, got it down with two, going into that fourth quarter, and looking for that patented big defensive push by the Indians like they do so many games. And the push was almost there, but it wasn't quite. But they forgot to remind themselves that beyond defense, they actually had to put the ball in the hole, too. And they weren't getting that done. They had the opportunity with Kenny down low. They had Jackson with three fouls. But it seemed like when Kenny would get the ball, he'd want to pass it back to somebody else instead of being aggressive and going to the hoop and picking up the basket plus a foul on the big man, Jackson.
Yeah, you can't fault Kenneth's defense tonight. Kenneth, I think, played a very, very good defensive game and gave the offense opportunities. The offense had way too many turnovers. You also give lots and lots of credit to Dexter the way they managed the game.
Let me tell you, that Jason Gerald is about as fine a basketball mind for a high school basketball player as you'll see. His presence on the floor, just like that play right down below us where everybody else thought the ball was going out of bounds.
Right.
He had presence of mind to not only get to the basketball to save it from going out of bounds, but then send it to one of his players in their front court and get a bucket.
Get a bucket and one, and turned a Kennett possession into a three-point play for Dexter. And Dexter did a lot of that. Kennett would make a run, do something spectacular, get some steals, and then you look up Dexter scoring 4 points and extending their leads. Give a lot of credit for Dexter for the way they handled. They were very, very efficient on offense. They had a good game plan, and they executed the game plan.
They know how to handle the basketball, and they handle it in a way that they're looking constantly while they're handling, looking for the best shot they can possibly get, not just an open man, but an actual really good high percentage type shot. And Kennett seemed to, all night long, just look for an open man. And just an open man doesn't always get you a good shot.
Now, that's been one of the problems with Kennett this year is shot selection. It's, taking the first open shot instead of the best open shot. But the defensive effort by Kennett, I thought, was just outstanding. I thought their defense really gave them a chance to win the game. And the offense just didn't pull it off. And again, Dexter's offense did. They were very efficient. They scored 55 points, but scoring 14, 13, 15, and 15 in the quarter. So they didn't have any ups and, big runs, big ups and downs. They were just very efficient, and that's what won the game. Let's wrap it up. Let me go through the scoring real quick. For Kennett, Rantrell Carruthers had seven. Carlos Turner with 11. Fred Gooden led with 12. 8 points to Jad Kinney, but only two in the second half. Six to Jahada Childress. He had two threes. Tariq Thomas with two. Patrick Maddox with two. For Dexter, the leading scorer of the game was Jason Gerald. He had 20. Ethan Flowers had 16. We mentioned Ethan Flowers. Gerald with the ball in his hand. Ethan Flowers has a spot up three. He had four threes. You can't leave him open. He made Kennett pay. He had 16. Gabe Jackson had 12, but he just had two in the second half. And 7 points to Jacob Pettigo for the 55 points for Dexter. Well, it's been fun, Daryl. We've had a good time. It was a good game. It was a game, you know, where Kennett kept coming back, but Dexter kept stretching it out. We had fun. You had a great TV debut, and I think we're showing the world that we both have faces for radio.
That's exactly right. Now you know why for so many years I did radio, not TV. But it was a great time. Thanks for having me out.
We thank you, Daryl, for Terry McVeigh, Daryl Wilcox, and Tyler Wagner. Thanks for tuning in. We've had fun. I hope you have too. Good night. Good luck.
Good night.